Hi everyone, this is Ramona coming back at you. Okay, so today I want to talk to you about who is your enemy. Okay, I think that this is a really important topic because, you know, I think that people throw the word enemy around like it really is nothing. And people are spreading hatred to other people, maybe a targeted person, like it's okay and that it's nothing. When in actuality, it's not okay and it is something, okay? Because the words that you speak, the thoughts that you do, the gossip that you're doing to other people, gossip kills, I'm telling you. And if you're a spiritual person, as you must be if you're watching my video, you're a pagan, Wiccan, Santeria, whatever it is that you follow, you know that words can hurt, especially when you have that angst and that energy behind it, like, oh, I can't stand out, oh, I hate it, oh, da, da, da. And then you're calling your friends, and now you have two and three and four people, just like, you know, and the cloud of negativity is getting bigger and bigger and bigger, and it's impacting that person who you're talking about. I have been a victim of being the middle of some serious gossip, and I'm talking about not about five people, ten, I'm talking about a whole community full of people who have risen up against me, don't like me, and all because of an abusive person who used to be in my life, okay? Some people are just really nasty and ugly, you know, but I'm just trying to tell you that the words that you use, the energy that you use those words with, how you treat other people, is just, it's really, really wrong. And you're targeting people and you're calling that person, oh, she's my enemy. And it's really, really sad because, you know, people will call somebody who's an enemy just because if you're walking down the corridor and somebody bumps into you and, you know, you're like, oh, I don't like her. She bumped into me the other day and she didn't even turn around to apologize. It only takes something that little tiny for somebody to say, you know what? I don't like her. Hey, Sarah, Julia? Yeah, do you like her? Yeah, I don't like her. And then it spreads from one person to the next person, and then everybody's like really, really looking at Julia, like, all because she bumped your shoulder and she didn't turn around to apologize. Now she's your enemy, and now she's worth you bringing a whole slew of people and turning them against her. And it's sad because these days there are a lot of sheeple out there, and you would think that a grown-ass woman or a grown-ass man would stop and say, you know what, why are you so upset with her? Why are you so vindictive now? Why, you know, well, Julia always said, oh, it was nice to me, she had never problems, I've never had issues or problems with her. Like, nobody stops and does that anymore. So I really want you to think about who it is that you're calling your enemy, okay? Now, we can even raise that up to something that's more significant. Maybe you have a coworker who is competing for the promotion, and, you know, she's not stepping on your toes, she's not doing anything that she shouldn't do or he shouldn't do, other than putting more hours in, busting their haunches all week long, even on the weekends. They're going over and beyond the top to impress the boss, to do the best job that they can, you know. And even if it's not just a momentary a point of impressing the boss, they're just really great workers. They love their job. They love the job that they do. And then they know that doing a job, if you're going to do any job, you need to do it well and good. And that's their mentality. They're really positive people, happy, you know, and do it with a skip. And, you know, because sometimes there's going to be people out there who are just better at doing things than you are. Where, same thing, like, you're going to be better at something than other people are. But the point here is that, you know, you really feel like you can't compete, or maybe if you did put as much work in your work to impress the boss or be just a better worker, you don't want to put in that extra effort. You never had to put in that extra effort before until she came along or he came along, and so now the boss is looking at you like, yeah. And then she's looking at this girl over here, this woman over here, or this man. Like, yeah, this is an awesome worker. A really awesome worker. Great stuff. Good girl. Yeah, she's going to get the promotion. And that person's probably been there for only like a year when you've been there for 5 years. You know what I mean? And, you know, so she or he's outshining you. She's so bright that you look kind of and scuzzy, like, yeah, you know. And so you go ahead and look at that person, your coworker, as enemy number one, and we need to bring her down. And then now you're going out of your way over and beyond to bring that person down. And if you're a spiritual person, even if you're not a spiritual person, gossip, words, thoughts, the energy behind that, I'm telling you, it creates something significant and it can harm. I can't stress that any more than I am right now. We are energetic human beings. There's energy around us. Every time I lift my hand, I've created a domino effect. It's gonna affect something, okay? And I know that sounds, but you know, but even every action that we do in the world, you give somebody a dirty look, I mean, that could really impact somebody who's just on the edge. They are already, you think you're just like, oh, whatever. But you just gave a dirty look to somebody who didn't deserve it. And who was probably on the edge already. Maybe they're suicidal. Maybe there was just a death in that person's family. And here you might just get, you shot that person a dirty look for apparently no reason, for like a stupid reason, okay? You can seriously cause somebody harm. Oh my God. You never know what that person is going to go home to. Maybe even if you cause that person to cry, and it's not just your dirty look, but it's the dirty look of other people. It's the craziness that person's going through, and you know, they're just like breaking. They break down. Like, do you want to add on to that? Do you know what I mean? And so, you know, enemies. Okay, so let's just go back to enemies, because I feel like I'm just, I kind of flopped off to that a little bit. So I just want you I want to get a little deeper into this, okay? So I really want you to stop and figure out what is an enemy. Is an enemy what I just explained, somebody who just ticked you off for today, or has consistently been ticking you off because it's a coworker or a family member, you know what I mean? But is just their existence of doing whatever it is that they're doing, living their life separately, not even thinking about you, but it's an aggravating you, it's an annoying you, is that really an enemy? Is it? And say if somebody really is kind of out to get you a little bit, if not out to get you, even in passing, and many times in passing, they may say like something rude to you, or maybe they are gossiping about you. We need to really become responsible to our responses to those people, and what we plan to choose on how to handle that situation. because so many people these days, they jump from down here all the way up here instead of taking steps in order to fix a situation. And I guess I'm going to get to a point because, like, I keep mentioning this is a spiritual, you know, this is on spirituality and magic as well, okay? You really need to stop. Before you go ahead and you hack somebody, you curse somebody, or whatever it is that you plan on doing to the enemy, who's not really an enemy, is just somebody who is really annoying the crap out of you, making your life a little uncomfortable, not based on them harming you or wanting to hurt you or not targeting you, but they're just living their life and they're separately and they're just annoying you from a distance. Those are not your enemies. Those are not your enemies. And it takes a grown woman and a grown man to really sit down and get a grip of your own emotions, your own feelings. Yes, we have them, and yes, they can be over the top sometimes. When we have jealousy, oh, that can send people over the top. Yes, it can. If you have a characteristics about yourself, of your personality, where you know you can be controlling, you know that it's my way or the highway, and I can't handle if I can't get my own way. If you know that is about yourself, you need to stop and figure out, am I just, you know, being me, or does this person really deserve harm? And if I'm just being me, what can I do about this person? Because, you know, even if I'm being me, this person's still getting on my nerves. It's still aggravating the crap out of me. Well, what can I do about that other than destroying that person's life or just bringing them down with curses and hexes and et cetera? You know? There's always different ways. So even if somebody's gossiping about you, there's different ways that you can cleanse yourself. You know, in your home, you can break. So that gossip and that negative energy that's inadvertently being sent off to you, breaking things down in your home, sending you bad luck, because everything's, you know, because that's what gossip can do. There's other things that you can do before you go to the big guns, okay? You can smudge your home. That would really, really work. I know that I have different faiths that I follow, but I read from the Bible. I did a book review about a long time ago about how different psalms can really, really create, and that's just not in Christianity. This is also in Santeria as well, that they would use it. But in Santeria and in Christianity, they really, really work with the Psalms big time, okay? There are books out there. You can look back at my one of my videos. Like I said, it was so long ago, I can't remember even the name of the video. But it's Psalms. It has the word Psalms in there. But there are different Psalms that you can read. Those are magical spells that you can use in a Bible. Yes, I did say it. Magical spells that are in the Bible. A gift to you. Okay, for you to use. If you're not in the know, of course you don't know that. Even if you've been a Christian all your life, you still don't know that this is. I mean, even Jesus has said that there's magic in the world. It's true. He's a magician himself, you know, so it's like, okay. But if you read certain verses, certain books, certain psalms, sorry, if you read certain psalms that and you know which psalms to read to help you in certain situations. I wish I had my book here, but I don't. I didn't think I was going to talk about that. You can read those and ask to you know, intercede and really get some blessings. And I promise you, things will change. Things will change. You have to be consistent in doing that. But, you know, you can also have your book, a Bible, up on a high, high shelf, the highest place in your home, and open it to page, to Psalm 93. It's protection for your home, okay? Of course, you have to read it once in a while. Holy sage. You can also put salt in all the corners of your house. There are witches' bottles that you can put. I can't do that here because I live in a community that, like, there's cameras everywhere. There's just, you step too close to the grass, they'll scream at you. So there's not, I can't do that here. But yeah, there's many things that you can do just to protect your home and protect yourself, to cleanse yourself. Spiritual baths, you can do that. So there's different steps that you can do before you go ahead and attack your enemy. So it's all about just try, number one, to protect yourself. So if they want to gossip and they want to do, it's not going to affect your money. It's not going to affect your livelihood. You know, anything that's important to you that you have the right to have, it's not going to affect it. And I myself, I feel like that I'm doing this video because I myself have been slacker, and so I made a promise to myself that after I clean the house every day, which I do before the boys wake up, I once over will sage my home, thinking about doing it twice. So once in the morning and then once in the evening. And I'm gonna consistently stick with that because after I sage my home, oh my God, I still feel spirits in the house. I don't know if anybody else feels that. Well, like if you can sense spirits. But the energy is completely different. It's just different, and it feels so good. Actually puts a smile on my face, but I haven't been smiling too much these days because I have been slacking off, and I do have issues with people in my community because of one person spreading a thick lies and just not right. I believe that it will, in the end, it will get fixed. But now I want to come to this. So yeah, let me just make sure that I sew that up really good. So if before you go ahead and call somebody your enemy and attack and gossip about the person or taking steps to magically bring this person down, figure out who your enemy really is, because people who are just living their lives, and I know I gave you two examples, but people who are like just living their lives and they just seem to annoy you from afar, not your enemy, darlings. They're not your enemies, and you have no right to bring them down the way they, most of you do, a lot of you do. Sometimes, and I've done this. I'm not saying that I'm Mrs., because I've done that a few times. You get caught up because I myself tend to forget to have maturity to control your thoughts, control my feelings. I can go over there, ratchet, or I can learn how to wrap it up, change my mind to something that's more positive. They piss me off and they're entering my mind, and that has happened to me almost to the point of like obsessive, because they're just really annoying. And then I'll get on the phone like to my friend, you know, like, I've done that. Now I'm just learning how to like really wrap it up, get a grasp of your own feelings, your own thoughts, and divert your attention elsewhere to things that are more needing. Okay. Taking care of business or just focusing on being happy. Pick up a book, pick up a broom, go to work, do whatever it is that you have to, take care of the kids, do whatever it is that you got to do that's more in a positive light, because over here you're just wasting your energy on somebody who's just not even knowing you exist. They're just carrying on their life. They are not your enemies, okay? Now, even if they were gossiping and stuff like that, there's a way of, number one, being, you know, taking responsibility for yourself once again. Why do my eyes look like they're like, ooh, you know, googly? Anyway, I think it's this camera. Taking responsibility, because there does take two, even if you're the one that's like, sit back. But if somebody has targeted you a bit, like, you know, and just really being a nuisance in your life, protect yourself first. Protect. Now, I want to go over, and I don't want to make this video too long, but now I want to go over to, okay, so we've established that this person is numero uno, enemy number one, okay? We've established that. Okay, now I give you some examples, okay? Now, you have seriously sat down and you're like, okay, you know what? Which I've done. I want to carry on my life. I've got goals, I've got dreams, I've got aspirations. I'm happy to be alive. I'm just, you know, I just want to carry on with my life and just think of my stuff that I got to think about. Because I know that if I'm over here on their road trying to fuss and fight with them, guess whose road's getting neglected? Your own road to betterment. It's getting neglected. Don't neglect yourself. Love yourself enough to not neglect your road. Don't waste your time being on bickering, because a lot of times people who are gossiping about you and you know that you're a good person, they can't be changed. They cannot be changed. They're just gonna be who they're gonna be. Some people are just really nasty and ugly. Some people, they don't care. They don't care if you're a good person. They're miserable by themselves, so they want to bring you down or him down or whoever they can get their hands on. They just want to bring them down, bring them on their path so they don't feel so alone, lonely in their negative world of Yucksville. Okay. But if you truly do have an enemy, okay, and somebody has seriously targeted you, and I'm not talking about being an annoyance because we went over that, okay? I'm talking about these people or this person, he, she, is going out of their way to disrupt your life, to the point where they are going to take away anything that is important. They know that's important to you, and they're going to try to take it away from you. And they go out of your way to magically, or with their own actions, even if they're not into magic, okay? Even with their own actions, they're trying to take you down. They're being stinky. They're being underhanded, sneaky fish. And they just don't like you for whatever reason. You know you're a good person, so it's not you. It's just sometimes good people, no matter how good you are, you will get targeted. You're going to get enemies. That's just fact. So if this person is like trying to make you lose your job or lose your housing, or reporting you for this, that, and the other, calling social services on you and your children, doing, which thank God, it didn't happen to me. But like, if they are really, really getting people, calling people to threaten you in the streets, so now you're getting things thrown at you, followed around. I'm telling you, there's some sick, nasty people in this world. Especially, you know, I always say that because maybe I don't have that experience I do have that experience of living country and living in a suburban area. And I just don't remember any of this, maybe because I was a child, but I don't remember the world being so sick or, you know, So I always say maybe it's just living in the city and the people just like a pot of just sickos. I don't know, but it's just like, you know, it's hard to find like a good person these days, you know. But yeah, if you really do have somebody who's going out of their way to just, they are willing, they're, until they see you alone, by yourself, jobless, moneyless, hopeless, homeless, until they see you to that point, they're not going to be happy whatsoever. And they're not going to stop until they see you get there. And I have come in contact with people like that, unfortunately. Now it's time for you to protect yourself on a whole nother level, okay? Because your mindset shouldn't be about, they're pissing me off, so I'm gonna piss them off. That's, you know, they're bringing me down, I'm gonna bring them down. It's not about war. It's about, you should have that mentality of protecting yourself. So now you gotta do, if, because I'm not the person who I wanna ever, I don't like it. Even if they're attacking me to the point where I'm just like down, I'm down and I'm getting kicked, spit on and pissed on. And that was really gross. But I have been attacked that way and still my heart is like, but I don't wanna like make them lose their home. I don't want them to, you know, that, you know. But when somebody comes at you like that, it is time to become the warrior. It is time to pack, you know, get yourself prepared, fix your mentality, because you deserve to have the freedom to be happy, the freedom that everybody else has in this world. You deserve to not have, you're not a slave. You're not a slave to your enemy. And if they choose to harm you to that point, now is the time to call them an enemy. And it is time to bring them down. Which, I think I made, the last video I made, I said at the tail end there that I wanted to talk about how we can bring our enemies down. Not because we hate them, but because we need to protect ourselves. There are things that I had to do in order to bring them down, and I still am like kind of debating. There is a reason why if, you know, I feel like one day I'm going to, you know, make all this video, like I feel like, but for now I feel like there's a reason why I have to keep it quiet, and I don't think it's because of you guys. I think that there's a stronger reason why, because I'm dealing with the issue right now, that I'm going to have to go there in order to protect myself. I'm going to have to go to the lengths of protecting myself. But me telling, making it public, making a public announcement of what I plan to do, A, B, C, D, E, F, G, I'm planning to do all of these things, I think subconsciously, or my spirit is talking to me, like telling me, Ramona, shh. Not now, later, right now, keep your mouth shut. So that is why I'm not going to share about things that I have actually done. I 2 years ago, where I had to do the same thing. Same people who've now come back, and you know, so I'm not gonna go any more into that. But this video was all about making it very clear about who is your enemy and who is not your enemy. Don't throw that word around like it's nothing, okay? And don't react, like don't call somebody who's really not your enemy and react to them like the way that you would react to a real enemy. Just don't do it. Because if they don't deserve that, there is a threefold law. There is such thing as karma. It will come back around and bite you. Beep. It is. And then also, we are here to spiritually, to learn spiritual growth, to grow as people, to become, to optimize our spirit as best we can. And that means taking care, learning how to control our emotions, learning how to control our reactions, learning how to become mature men and women. We're not children. And we shouldn't run wild and rampant dealing with other people. These people are our brothers and sisters. Your neighbors are brothers and sisters. You know, sometimes with brothers and sisters, you can't really be close, you know what I mean? But you should think of that foremost. I think just, you know, take care of your spirit, you guys. Learn, grow, mature, and become the optimum best of you. And be okay with that at the end of the day. You know, really work on yourself. Like, be okay with that at the end of the day where you're feeling good about yourself. So, okay, you can't, like, throw it all on that one person who's annoying you, because that feels good momentarily. But if you're a good person, at the end of the day, you have to look at yourself in that mirror. And by them, that doesn't feel very good. And damn, it is now coming back to me. Because if you stop, if you're the one who listens and pays attention, you will know backlash when it comes knocking. It's your turn now, sister. It's your turn now, brother. You did this, and now here's your backlash. So think about that. I'd rather not be fear of the punishment. I would rather step up to take responsibility. Okay, so let's wrap this up. And okay, hope you guys like this video. Mwah! Love everybody. Bye.